Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week I have another composite for you. We're going to combine four different photos to make one image. We're going to start off with this image that we have on the screen here. The first thing we'll do is duplicate this layer with a Command J. So we can turn off the bottom one at the moment, we don't need to have that one turned on. And the first thing I'm going to do is come over here to my triangle tool and pick the triangle tool here, making sure my fill is on white. Just going to draw a triangle out and click on my move tool here and drag my triangle over onto my picture. I'm going to rotate the triangle now, holding my shift key down. I'm going to turn it all the way around until it snaps so it's level, and I'm going to move it up the top and drag out the triangle over to each edge of the picture. I'm going to drag the triangle down here on my ruler on the side here down to 2200, all the way down to 2200 just here. And if you don't see your rulers on Affinity Photo, you can come up here to View and Show Rulers. Make sure Show Rulers is ticked here. Okay, once I've got my triangle in place, I'm going to right click on my triangle and rasterize it. I want the triangle to be a pixel layer, so I've got a pixel layer here. I'm going to grab now my flood selection tool, click on my flood selection tool, and turn my tolerance up to 20%. So it's all the way up to 20. And I'm going to click once on my triangle, and it should give you a selection all around that triangle. Make sure you click on the background layer here, and then you can hit delete. You can see on the little thumbnail here, it's cut part of that picture out. We don't need our triangle anymore, so let's click on our triangle, come down here to the trash can and click delete that triangle layer. We can get rid of the marching ants now with a Command D or Escape on our keyboard. Now you can see we've got a cutout of our triangle. We're going to add our next element now, and that's going to be our zip here. And you can already see I've used my selection brush tool and I've made a selection of the zip. So with my selection of the zip, I'm just going to go Command C. I'm back to my picture and Command V. Clicking on my move tool, I'm just going to make that zip a little bit smaller and move it into place. Make it a little bit smaller again and just move it into place at the bottom of that triangle there. Now I'm going to remove all the black around the zip here. So I'm going to make sure that I'm on my zip layer and I'm going to get my flood selection tool again. This time I'm going to bring the tolerance down to 10%, all the way down to 10. And I'm going to click on the black part of the zip, hit delete on that side, come over to this side, hit delete on that side, and just take care of these little sections down here as well. As you can see, it's left a lot left over, but we've got to get rid of these marching ants. So let's go Command D over to our erase tool. Going to make my brush a little bit bigger with my right and left bracket keys, and I'm just going to delete these sections here that we don't need. So let's get rid of that line all the way down to the bottom. Let's come on this side as well, do this side, and again, get rid of that black line all the way down to the bottom. We don't want to use that part of the zip. And then just a bit of tidy up on each side here of the zip. There we go. We've got rid of that. Let's zoom in a little bit with our Command Plus so we can see our zip here. We're still on our zip layer. We're going to grab our rectangular marquee tool here. And I'm going to draw a square just around the bottom part of the zip here. And as you can see, once we move over those lines now, it'll change so we can move it a bit. So I'm just going to move that up a bit. And it's about one, two, three, four little notches up from the bottom of the zip here. I'm going to make a copy just of that with Command J. And let's call that zip bottom. We'll just click on there and call that zip bottom, the bottom of the zip, and hit enter. Get rid of those marching ants with a Command D. Let's click back on the zip background. And still with our marquee tool here, I'm going to copy this side of the zip and just bring it up to about three notches off the bottom and just move that over. So I'm just getting this part of the zip. Command J again to copy that, and let's call that right zip and hit enter. back on the layer of the background, the whole zip here, and we can now move this selection over. So let's just move it over to the other side now and get the left hand side of the zip. So let's move it up a little bit and Command J. Of course, we're going to call that left zip. Hit enter. Okay, let's get rid of the marching ants, Command D or Escape. We can now click off this background layer. We don't need to see that background layer anymore. Let's click on the right hand zip and grab our move tool. Let's move it out the way and turn it. Let's bring it down. So we're just getting right on the edge, right on the edge of our triangle there, and bring it all the way down to the bottom. We're not quite on the edge there, so a little bit of manipulation. So let's zoom in a little bit more with our Command Plus and move up. Now let's use our arrow keys just to move in a little bit further. That's not looking too bad. Just make sure it's on the edge of the triangle here. So Command 0, that's looking pretty good. Let's go Command J again and copy that layer again and then move that one up the top here. And again, we just want it to fit into place. Let's zoom in, drag that down. I'm holding my shift key down so we can see where we are. And I'm going to use my arrow keys just to move that into place a little bit better. Command 0 to have a look. And that looks pretty good. Let's click on the left zip now. And let's do the same. Let's just move that around, bring it onto the edge of the triangle and move that around. Here we get it covering that triangle, and let's move down. Okay, we can zoom in again with our Command Plus and move that a bit closer. Let's have a look. And again, we can use our arrow keys. I'm just using my down arrow key just to move that into place a little bit. And let's just keep moving that down. And that looks okay. Let's go Command 0. Again, on that left zip, let's go Command J and make another copy. Move that all the way up as well and down. So again, we can just move that into place. Just use our arrow keys again, just so we can get a really good spot there. Command 0 to have a look. Looks like we need it just to move up a little bit. And we've got our zip in place. So for anybody that doesn't want to create the whole zip themselves, I have created it for you over here, and that will be available for you to download on the Buy Me a Coffee site. The link will be down below. It'll be absolutely free for you to download. Just remember, if you do use this downloaded zip that I have created on the Buy Me a Coffee site, you need to make sure that your triangle comes all the way down to 2,200. And that zip will fit perfectly into this picture. So that's available for you, as I said, absolutely free on the Buy Me a Coffee site. The link will be below. Okay, let's bring our next picture over. It's going to be the picture of the city here. So we'll go Command C, back over to our picture and Command V. Double click on the background of that picture so we can see where we can move this picture into place. And let's grab this picture and drag it all the way down below underneath the picture of the background with the cutout. Let's go Command 0 and let's make that picture a little bit better so it fits in there. I'm going to have the road so it's right in the middle of the zip here, and I want to see the peak of the tower here as well. So I'm just going to stretch that across so it fits into our picture and make sure my road is right in the middle there. Next thing I'm going to do on this background of our city, I'm going to lighten it up a bit. So I'm going to add a curves down here on the adjustments, click on curves, and I'm just going to clip it to that layer of the picture. So the curve only affects the background of the city here. And I'm simply just going to drag that curve up till it brightens that picture quite a bit, actually, nice and bright so it matches the rest of the picture here, and click off our curves. Okay, we're all ready to bring our next picture over, which is going to be the picture of our model on the ladder here. And again, you can see I've used my selection brush tool to make a selection. There's a few tricky little selections on this ladder. So I'll just zoom in and you can see there's some tricky little sections here and in here, and just some tricky little sections up here. So just make your brush nice and small. Keep resizing your brush. Hold your option key down to get into these really tight spots here and make your selection all the way around the ladder. Okay, Command 0 to make it back to normal size. And I'm going to copy this picture, Command C, back over to our picture and Command V. Now, this picture we want all the way on top, so let's move it all the way on top here. And let's move our picture into place. So I'm just going to move it in a tiny bit and down. I'm going to use the ladder to cover up some of that zip where it sort of turns to go up into the picture. So I'm just going to move that down a little bit, and I want her shoulders sort of just above the zip line, looking over the top of that zip. Okay, before we move on, let's blend our model into the picture so she looks a little bit more like she belongs. Let's come up here to Select and Selection from Layer. It's going to put that selection back on our model here. I'm going to add a new pixel layer down here, and with my color picker here, I'm going to pick that dark color in the corner and activate that color. I'm going to click on my paintbrush here. Make sure I have a nice soft brush, and I'm going to just paint over the model. I do need my flow and my opacity to be at 100%, and I'm just going to paint over my model here and the ladder. Paint all that dark color into that selection. There we go. Make sure we get it all. And then on my blend mode here, I'm going to change that to soft light. I'm going to add another pixel layer. And then I'm going to use my color picker to make a nice light color. The cloud here, activate that new pixel layer. We're still on our brush. And let's paint again the ladder and our model. So we've got that color all over. And this time I'm going to change the blend mode to multiply. And on both of those layers, I'm going to highlight both of those layers holding my shift key. And I'm going to bring my opacity down to 50%. Have a look at that. That's looking pretty good, making that picture blend in a little bit better to the photo. Let's get rid of our marching ants, Command D or Escape. Going to group these three layers together, holding my shift key down to select them all, Command G. And I'm just going to call that model. And on the model group, I'm going to add a layer mask. So I've got my layer mask here. Still got my brush. Going to change my flow down to 25%. My opacity can stay at 100%. All the way down to 25. Let's get our colors back to default. Hit D on my keyboard and X to change them around on my keyboard so I've got black. Making my brush a little bit bigger. And then I'm just going to hide the bottom of that ladder into the grass here. There we go. Just so that ladder looks like it's going into the grass and you can't see the bottom of it. There we go. We've got our ladder and our model. Going to add another pixel layer on the top, all the way up the top. Grab my color picker. Going to grab this sunshine type color. And I'm going to change my opacity all the way down to about 30, quite low. And I'm going to drop my flow down to about 15, I think. I'm going to activate that color and just use my Command Plus to make the picture a little bit bigger. Make my brush quite a bit smaller. And I'm just going to add some highlights to her shoulder and her face. That sun, the last of those sun's rays coming through also on my zip here, just a few on my arm and on the ladder. Down here a little bit as well. Very subtle. Command 0. Have a look at that. Not too bad. Turn it down a little bit. Maybe down. Yeah, let's turn it down to 50% and have a look. Just very subtle little highlights. Okay, one more pixel layer right on top. I'm going to move this one all the way under the zips here. All the way under the zips. I'm going to hit D on my keyboard to get my colors back to default. I want black. I want my flow up to about 20. And I think I'll put my opacity up to about 50 and we'll see how we go. I want my brush a little bit bigger, and right up the top here in the corner, I'm going to click once. And then I'll bring my brush all the way down to this corner here. Hold my shift key down and click once as well. Let's do the same in this corner, right up in the corner here, all the way down to this corner. Hold your shift key down and click once. And that's just given my zip a little bit of depth. Let's just put a little bit on the bottom here, click once, and down as well. Let's just give our zip a little bit of depth there with that little bit of shadow. So there we go, everybody. That is looking pretty good. Let's now highlight all of our layers. Hold shift, highlight all the layers, come up here to layer and merge visible. And what that's going to do is put all these adjustments, all these layers into one layer. Going to now come to my tone mapping and click on tone mapping. And I want this picture to sort of look a little bit dreamy with a lot more detail. So I'm going to click on detail, this one here, detail. I'm going to bring that right down to about 20%. All the way down to 20. And then on my contrast here, I'm going to bring that down to about -8. I'm going for that sort of dreamy look on this picture. So I'm really happy with the way that looks. So I'm going to hit apply. Sort of looking a little bit more like a painting than a photo, but that's sort of the look I'm going for. So the only thing you could do now at the end, if you wanted to, come down to adjustments, add a curves layer, and you could just flatten the blacks a tiny bit more, bring that light dark down a tiny bit, and just have that S curve if you would like. That's given me sort of a dreamy looking photo with a bit of detail in it. I'm quite happy with. There you go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week. 4 different photographs blended in together. My model looking over the top of the zip into New York City. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I upload my next video. But until then, I'll say to you, stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you in my next video.